it's a daunting task to speak after all this wonderful insight. But I'd like to put to you the question, why are you here? And suggest that we all have something in common. We are passionate leaders who desperately want to be part of the solution to the ever-increasing social problems that we're facing. And I'd like to put an argument on the table. We spend most of our time hanging out with, talking like, dressing like people who are just like us. Yet our greatest gains as human beings are when we connect with people who are really diverse and different from us, who challenge us, who take us outside our comfort zone, and maybe they might disagree with us. I like to call that positive human collisions or creative abrasion. And I would like to suggest that that is something that we all need to do on a regular basis. And I'm going to explain in this talk why that is so important. So, as we've seen today, trust in our institutions is at an all-time low, and we as individuals are searching as tribes and communities for the solutions. As you can see from that statistic, and as was mentioned by Peter this morning, it is estimated that up to 60% of current middle-class jobs will be made redundant due to robotics, artificial intelligence, and new technologies over the next decade. We talk more to boxes and screens than we do to one another, and it becomes fundamentally important to nurture the attributes of human beings that set us apart from machines: love, courage, compassion, creativity. Our social issues are increasing and growing. Loneliness and social isolation is the global epidemic of our times. We have rising complex social disadvantage in Australia, and all of the research and evidence shows that these complex problems can only be solved at a local level with a whole of community approach, just as Pradeep was suggesting. What our government has done and has been, our governments, I guess, have been spectacularly unsuccessful at solving our social problems. We silo and fund every type of social problem separately. In one corner, migrants; in another, elderly; in another, unemployment, and so on. This fails to recognise the complexity of human beings. It also fails to recognise that every time we provide a handout, someone will expect that handout. So at Creativity Australia, we have a mission to do things differently, to bring together the fortunate and the less fortunate as one, to level the playing field, not to create programs for disadvantaged people that we think they might need, but actually to come together in one group on a regular basis and change things up. We use this model of a social inclusion continuum. So, of course, all of us in this room are on the very lucky side in the green, in the included. Would you agree? Little crowd participation?
Yes.
Thank you. And on the other side, once we get to chronic exclusion, it's pretty hard to rehabilitate someone once they're there, and it's costing us as taxpayers a lot of money. So it stands to reason that we need to focus on this middle section, people who may go down the slippery slope of chronic exclusion. So through a range of life events, you can get into that area or you can be in that area. Maybe loss of a spouse, a job, a whole range of different things. And my suggestion today, and the work that we're doing with our team at Creativity Australia, is that we need to keep crossing the bridge, and that we will in our lives. Because I think we need to make no mistake about it. For those of you that were here this morning and saw people in the choirs, there was a mix of people like you, corporates, and less fortunate. And we could swap places with any of those people at any time. It's just the luck of the draw that we happen to be sitting here in this room. So my suggestion is that we need to focus on programs where we can cross the bridge and not stay in our little boxes and our little silos. To build a circle of care where in our programs we connect with local governments, with local welfare agencies, with local businesses and local residents to solve problems for diverse people of all ages, all backgrounds, and all faiths. there's not the program for the disadvantaged people that's going to solve things. Together we are the problem and we are the solution. So, look, you've seen it all today. The neuroscience of singing is profound, and I'm not going to go into it today, but some of you have asked about my TED Talk, which is called How Singing Together Changes the Brain. In there, you can see exactly the super effects of singing. But singing is only one of the activities that could be used in a model of levelling the playing field. It could be cooking, it could be dancing, it could be anything that brings us all together so that we realise we're one and the same. So this morning you will have seen Annabelle speak, and for those of you that were not here, we have a wish list program. So through the neuroscientific benefits of singing, we empower people to ask for help and to give help. So anyone can make a wish each week, which is read out by a wish list volunteer. It can be help with a phone, a fridge, accommodation, a resume, finding a job, a partner, learning English, learning the internet. The wishes are read out and instantaneously people start raising their hands and granting one another's wishes. It's like a weekly miracle, I can tell you. And over 2,500 wishes have been granted so far, leading to hundreds of jobs, employment, well, jobs and employment, and of course, even marriages, though we're not a dating agency. So the key features of the program, the choirs rehearse every week. That's fundamental. It's like a weekly home and haven for many people. They share supper and the wish list. And people like all of us pay a small membership, which is tax deductible, to be in the choir. And those who are less fortunate pay what they can, or if they can't, nothing at all. We have a giving circle so that anyone in this room or in the choirs or in the community can support the participation of a disadvantaged person for just $10 a week or $500 a year. And that's a life-changing gift. Our impact over the past 8 years has been immense, with over 20 programs, thousands of participants, hundreds of volunteers. So each of our programs has 6 to 10 volunteers. They perform in their local communities, generating pride and teamwork. And there's been hundreds of connections to health, well-being, hope and joy. We had an evaluation from Swinburne which showed that participants experience 98% less de-stressing, or less stress, I should say. So if you want to come to With One Voice, you will experience a lot less stress. 80% felt reduced anxiety and depression, and 70% of people gained new skills for life and work. So at the moment, in this 8 years, and I want to acknowledge the incredible team at Creativity Australia and also wonderful philanthropists like Alan English, like Greg, like Peter, who've helped us really to reposition ourselves. We have been a very, I guess, traditional DGR charity, and we're now repositioning ourselves into a social franchise. So Transformation A involves building the ultimate social franchise model. And what we've done through the philanthropy and support of a number of visionary philanthropists is create incredible tools so that any person who is passionate in a community and wants to start up a With One Voice program can use our video tutorials, our written guides, and our mentoring to start a program. In addition to that, we've actually made some seed funding available, so the communities can compete for this funding, and the best With One Voice communities that show us they can really meet our criteria are starting to win those grants. We're also developing the talent, the conductors, because I can tell you the sort of person like you saw this morning, Kim Dillon, doesn't just grow on trees. These sort of people are hard to find and need to be trained to really connect with diverse community members. We've been scaling the model from Melbourne to just recently setting up 2 new programs in Port Macquarie and Canberra using some seed funding grants. On the other side, our Transformation B, I guess, is creating the ultimate social business fundraising challenge. And this is where all of you can get involved. And by the way, for those of you sitting there thinking, oh, but I can't sing, this is not for me, Just let me say, when I was 14, I was told never to bother having singing lessons. And I'm sure if I asked all of you in the room now who's been told they can't sing, hands up if you've been told you can't sing. Right, yeah. Common response. But we all have a voice, and the voice is the language of our hearts. So what we invite people to do is to sing a song with a group of two or more in their family, club, school, workplace, wherever they like, video it, pop it up on our Sing for Good channel, and then share it with friends and networks who donate to support lonely and isolated people in need. Now, this is like the next Movember, but without the moustaches. So we don't discriminate on age or sex. We invite you all to join us on August the 1st to October the 31st to raise funds. And we also have a joint fundraising platform in place so we can support other charities through this initiative. So I'm just going to show you 1 second of this video.
Go.
I heard he sang a good song. I heard he had a style.
By my side. And then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong.
And I learned how to get along, and so you're back. Walk out the door, just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to hurt me with goodbye? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, won't I die? I will survive.
Fighting forever, now we're united together. Two nations playing as one to reach our goal.
Way too fast.
Anyway, that gives you a sense of it, the diversity. So you can do this in any place with any group of you, just two or more people. It's not a selfie competition. And we challenge you to be part of the largest, we hope, social business fundraising competition. So this is our social business model: startup grants, empowering communities through the wish list and the giving circle and Sing for Good. I would like to suggest that community is our greatest asset, and together we can help people connect, care and be cared for. I do wish for a world where I can is more important than IQ, and we sure need that now. We all need to be can people. I'd like to leave you with a quote by Rabbi Hillel, who said, "If I'm not for myself, who will be for me? And if I'm only for myself, what am I? And if not now, when?" Ladies and gentlemen, together we can change the world, one voice at a time. Thank you.